Today we're going to tie the little black stone. Black stone is a very effective pattern in a short period of time here in the Northeast. The little blacks hatch. Quite often the weather disrupts them to where you never even see them, or they come off way too early. Sometimes they come off way before the fishing season opens on certain waters. But when you hit them right, it's an extremely effective pattern, and for a while through the spring they fish extremely well. I also like it for dredging in the winter. I start off with a size 10 standard nymph hook and 6-aught black uni thread. Wrap a thread base, and then I start by wrapping lead wire, medium lead wire, from the point of the hook, the length of the shank. You want this fly to get down. Usually you're fishing it in higher water to begin with. I wrap the lead wire to a point about one eye length behind the eye. And secure it. Don't overdo it. You're going to be wrapping over this quite a bit. And bring your thread back to the point of the barb. At this point, I take a small amount of peacock ice dub. You can do this in thread if you want. I find it ties in a little bit better. Form a ball. An eye length behind where the lead stops, wrap back, and then you're going to tie in your rear biots. I use dark brown turkey biot. You're going to tie it in that gap that was left between the ball of the dubbing and the lead wire. Tie it in on the side of the hook. Position it where you want it. Put that tied in a little short. I don't like that. Even, and then I trim off the butts. All right, next you're going to tie in your small black wire. I use ultra wire. Side of the hook, wrap back to the point of the tail, and then you're going to take a section of wild turkey tail, I make it a sizable section. It does bind down. I'd rather have it a little large than to be too small. I usually cut a section at least a quarter inch. It does bind down. And get it secured. And then I take 3 peacock herl, fairly large. Trim them even and tie them in at the butt ends back. And what you do in the end is bring their body flush. And then bring your thread forward to about the two-thirds point of the hook. This point you're gonna palm your peacock curl forward. Just gonna cover the lid. Tie it off. And then you're going to pull your wild turkey tail fibers forward and tie it off at the same point. Next step is to bring your wire forward. Bind down your abdomen. Tie off at the two-thirds point as well. At this point, you're going to tie in two biots across the top, right at the thorax. I crisscross these. I don't tie them in on the side. Tie them in on top. And get in position. Trim the butts. And make sure you're secured. And you're going to take your turkey tail and you're going to pull it back. It'll be a little stiff. You're going to bind it in out of the way. And you're going to dub your thorax. Thorax is going to be black ice dub. Be too small with the thorax, but you're not going to go nuts. It's going to be a tapered head. You don't want to build it up too bulbous. Just a little bit more. Not going too crazy. And then you're going to pull your wing case forward. And tie it in. Two on top. Three or four in front. This is a pretty thick wing case when you do it in this manner. And secure it down and build your head. whip finish. At this point, you can straighten out your bites since you probably abused them just a little bit. You want your bites to be slightly downward slanting. And then I use Sally Hansen's. I put a liberal coat the entire shell back. It soaks in quite well, but you want it heavy. And there it is, little black stone. An excellent midwinter pattern for searching. A great spring pattern when the black stones are coming off and you're lucky enough to hit them. Hope it adds to your box. Thank you very much.